Welcome back to another edition of The Breakdown, everybody. As the title suggests, this is going to be about who is Mike Locksley, new Alabama offensive coordinator as of January of this year. I'm going to give you kind of like some broad overarching ideas and details about his life and who he is and how, you know, his career has led him up to this point. I'm not going to go over every single detail. That would make this video way too long. I'm just going to go over some of the things I thought were interesting. And, you know, just kind of give you a story, something you could know about. So, first of all, Mike Locksley grew up in Washington, D.C. with the Ballou High School. And to this very day, he still recruits that area very well, well-respected in that area. And speaking of recruiting, he's a great recruiter overall. He's responsible over his career for recruiting people like Vernon Davis. Yes, that Vernon Davis. Stephon Diggs. Dwayne Haskins. Before he flipped to OSU this past year, and Aurelius Bennett. So he knows how to go out there and get some big names and bring people in. Going into his college career, he played at Towson State, which is, you know, in the Maryland area, as a DB, actually. He was a safety and a cornerback in his time there. This may explain why he is such a well-respected offensive mind, because he knows how defenses operate, so he would know how to, you know, attack them. He would know what to look for. He would know which things to scheme for. It makes sense. And he also got a degree in marketing. And so I'm wondering, why you bring that up? Now, this isn't causing this, but I figured there may be some correlation. You know, with marketing, you got to know how to, you know, sell things to people. You have to know how to talk to people. You have to know how to get them talking about things that they're interested in for your own purposes so that you can sell whatever you need to them. And that may explain why he's so good at recruiting. He knows how to market to people. So I just thought that was interesting. Maybe you all think so as well. Now, the following fall, after he graduated from Towson State, he graduated and then he became the defensive backs and special teams coach for Towson in 1992. So he went from playing to coaching immediately. Shows you how well respected he was. Then I'm going to skip 4 years because he has a few jobs here and there. But in 1996, he started coaching the tight ends in the split ends at Army. So he kind of, you know, he's moving up and moving around pretty quickly. Then he became the running backs coach at Maryland in 1997 under the head coach at the time was Vanderlinden, who also made him the recruiting coordinator. So he was the running backs coach and defensive coordinator. So he went from coaching DBs and safeties 5 years earlier to now being a running backs coach and a recruiting coordinator. In the year 2000, the head coach Vanderlinden for Maryland was fired. But new coach Ralph Friesen, yes, that Ralph Friesen, who, yeah, I wouldn't say he's a legend, but he's pretty well known out there in the coaching world. If you kept up with coaching, specifically Maryland, he was there for a while. Ralph Friesen was so impressed with him that he kept him. And this name, this shows you how coaches are so connected and how they all come together and good coaches hang out. But he kept Mike Locksley and James Franklin. So Locksley and Franklin were on the same staff at Maryland in their late 90s. Who knew, with Ralph Friesen, who knew that Maryland was the home of offensive genius? And maybe I'm just late to the party. I didn't know that. So he had those guys there. And then in February 2003, so we jumped ahead 3 years, Ron Zook, some of you Florida fans remember that, Illinois fans remember that, Ron Zook brought him to the University of Florida to be the running backs coach and the recruiting coordinator. So you see, you're starting to see a common symptom, you know, a common thing that's going along with him. You know, people are seeing that he's really good at recruiting and that he can coach, so they bring him in. So then in January 2005, Ron Zook hired Mike Locksley as the offensive coordinator at Illinois, which is where he went after he left Florida. So Mike Locksley was the offensive coordinator at Illinois from 2005 to 2008. And during his time in Illinois, he lured at least 9 players from the D.C. area. So that shows you how good of a recruiter he is. Mike Locksley was able to recruit his home area so well that he brought 9 players from D.C. to Illinois. To a program that wasn't really that successful at the time. He brought people in and they had a really talented offense. I know a lot of you guys remember Juice Williams and Rashard Mendenhall, who had a solid career with the Pittsburgh Steelers at the start of his NFL career, then kind of tailed off, and Aurelius Ben was over there, Daniel Dufresne. They had a really talented offense, and he was coordinating that and recruiting guys and brought them to it. And then in December of 2008, he was named the head coach of New Mexico Lobos. Now, unfortunately, his career there wasn't that successful. He went 2-26. He got fired in the first half of his third season there. So his head coaching career hasn't been great up until now. And it was a bunch of different reasons why he wasn't successful there. It was a bunch of factors. It was some personal issues that he had there, at least three different things that I won't go into. I'll leave that alone. But one thing that is always understated about it is that they already had NCAA probation under New Mexico at the time. I don't know what they needed it for. You know, they weren't that successful to begin with, so I don't know what they could have been in trouble for, but they were in trouble, so that makes it harder to recruit. That makes it harder to get everybody on the board, and so it really wasn't a good situation, and he got fired in the first half of his third season. Even with that, though, he was able to move on, and then the head coach of Maryland, again, so Maryland just seems to have respect for him. It brought him in, so he was with Maryland from 2012 to 2015. He was the offensive coordinator for 2 years, from 13 to 14, and then also in 15, but then the coach got fired. He became the interim head coach during that season. They didn't retain him, but Nick Saban at Alabama brought him in to be an analyst, and then he became an on-field coaching last year with the wide receiver coach and co-offensive coordinator, and now finally in January 2018, Mike Locksley is the Alabama offensive coordinator. A lot of things that led up to where he is now, and I honestly think he'll be successful. He's well-respected. I've heard stories, I've read things that say that there are coaches who come up to him, people like Kevin Sumlin and whatnot, they come up to him and ask him questions about what he would do in certain positions when he sees certain defenses, what offense would he run. So he's apparently well-respected even by other offensive coordinators, which is a good sign, means that he knows what he's doing. And he did all of this, you know, he was able to stay on the field coaching last year. This is one of the things that really kind of endeared me to him, or helped me to understand what he's like as a person, the type of concentration and drive that he has. His son, I don't know if a lot of you guys remember this, Alabama people, his son, Mike Locksley, died last year on September 3rd after the Florida State game. And he was able to continue coaching throughout the season. It was really sad to hear, you know, my condolences, you know, praise for the family. That was, I'm pretty sure that's really hard, and that's still hard. That wasn't that long ago. But for him to be able to continue coaching and go through what he did, I think that is a sign of great mental fortitude, emotional security. And I'm just wishing the best for him in the future. I want to see him succeed even after going through such a rough time over the last few years of his life. So that's all I'm bringing to you about Mike Locksley right now. I just want to let you know something about his life, something about who he is, some of his accomplishments, where he's been. And the next video, or at least the next installment to this Mike Locksley thing, will be about some of his plays, what he likes to do on offense, kind of like the type of style that he does. So that's what I'll be hoping to show you next time. Let me know what you think about Mike Locksley. Are you excited for him? Were you worried? Do you think he'll be successful here? What is the thing that you like most about Mike Locksley, and what are your expectations? Thank you for watching. I'll see you next time.